Hey folks, how you doing? Andy with you today. We're taking a look at the holy grail of audio engineering, taking a song and pulling out of it the individual instruments. Sacrilegious. How is that possible? It's taking a cake and unbaking it. It is possible thanks to the company is Hitnmix, the software is RipX, and they have three components to this software. You can buy just this one, the DeepRemix, but the other two are DeepCreate, which is more the creative tools, and the third one is Deep Audio, which is cleanup tools. You can buy this one just by itself if you like. But first of all, go and get yourself a free trial, 21 days, have a bash around with it. That's a very generous trial. So, what we do to begin with, we bring in a song. I bring in a wave here, and I'm using songs by my mates, and I'll give them a quick shout out as well while we're doing that. But you'll notice this interface comes up for you. So you can tick which instruments you want to isolate, extract, and so they've just done a recent update, which now includes separating guitar and piano. That was not possible before. So there was a lot of blending of getting the guitar and the piano on the same track. When I tried this track that I'm about to show you, it had piano and guitar coming through on the one track. I don't know if it will separate those because they are still stringed instruments, but I'm curious to see. You'll notice the more splitting things up that you do, the longer the ripping time is. So I'm going to do this. Previously only 5 minutes, now 13 minutes because we're extracting further. We hit rip, we go grab a drink, and then we come back. So the first song we're taking a look at is more on the electronic side of things, and then the other one I'm going to show you is more a analog band. They are a folk rock band. But this one is Audrey Vixen, good mate of mine. Trent does great stuff. I played guitar on one of his tracks, two of his tracks a while back, and so gave him a shout, and he does great electronic music and digital art, so be sure to check out Audrey Vixen. Here's the Facebook page. So, let's have a listen to the song in its original form. Not too many parts in this, very ambient. Check out over on the side, we've got our individual components here. Voice, guitar, bass, kick drum, percussion. There is a little bit of interpretation of what these instruments are. This one is actually instrumental, there's no voice in it. So it gives us a little simpler track to check out. And like any audio workstation, we've got our soloing and our muting available to us. We can also do things like panning, which is this little one here. When we hover over, we can go left and right. But let's first look at the magic, enough holding back on all those things. So if I come down here to the bass, let's solo the bass. And what it's done with the audio is given it a MIDI representation. You can see the notes of audio. How mind-blowing is that? We can do the opposite. We can mute the bass. On, off, on, off. Particularly good with electronic stuff. That's why I started with this one for you. Now, let's have a look at each of the individual tracks here, what it has interpreted. Has it interpreted anything as voice? I'd hope not. No, there's no voice. It's nice we get the visual sense. There is no guitar in this, but maybe there's something that is electronic that is similar to guitar. Yeah, so these synths have been interpreted as guitar, which is fine. You just gotta get clear on how it's dissecting the audio. As we had before, the bass. The kick drum, that's very obvious. How crazy is that isolation? And there's the percussion. Absolutely nuts. Now if we come back to, what was this guitar track? I'm just gonna isolate that one. Show you the panning. Oh, sorry, that's our volume. If I do the little triangle here, here we go. So we can actually do our EQ as well if we wanted to. Stereo field, there we go. Left side, right side. So you could do that within the mix. You can remix, literally. Beautiful. We could mess with the EQ if we wanted to. Whoa. There you go. All right, let's take a look at the other track, which is more of an acoustic band, which also has vocals. That is currently still importing, so a bit of magic. All right, our second track has imported here, very colorful looking. And this is Mary by Captain O'Brien's Crake. I hope I'm saying that right. These guys are folk rock. And the thing I will note is that we've got a color for each of these instruments. So that's kind of a cool aspect to this as well. All right. Banjo. Guitar. Bass. Would the story sound the same if you told it a different way? Would you still be here? Check out the vocals. Blown me away. How clean that is. Tiny bit of violin there. Piano in this song. Kick drum. Drums. We're just picking up just the snare. Primarily the snare. And percussion is everything else. Bit of snare there as well. Strings! Hey. Alright, let's go back to the start there, see how it picked up the banjo. Has it integrated it to strings or has it integrated it into the guitar? Strings. There you go. So we can flip this the opposite way. We can mute tracks as well, as I was saying in the previous song. So let's jump ahead. Goodbye banjo. Goodbye bass. Would the story sound the same? Karaoke, let's get rid of the vocals. Damn cool, hey. So many possibilities. So there is a whole heap of tools that we've got over here, but I'm gonna leave that to the Deep Create video, which really optimizes on those things. So there you go, that really is the primary purpose of Deep Remix. It is splitting up the audio and being able to solo or mute individual tracks within an entire mix. So who is this handy for? Or what purpose is it mostly handy for? Well, the big one is, of course, learning songs, being able to isolate things, hear them by themselves. And the other purpose is creating backing tracks for a song that, for instance, you're learning. I put on concerts for my students over the years, and I've either done one of two things. I've either gone and bought backing tracks or just got them to play along with the original song. The problem with that is they're adding then extra guitar on top. So to be able to have the original song and then be able to just pull the guitar out and you be the guitarist, amazing, amazing stuff. So go and grab your free trial of it now. It is available for you. You get 21 free days of the trial. And yeah, check out this page here that I've got linked as well, which is all the info. I really just touched the very surface, but really focused on the key aspects of this. All right, and also check out the other two components that I've got videos on, which are Deep Create and Deep Audio. See you for those.